We came and played here last year, and it was the highlight of our tour. We played almost 100 shows in the U.S. and Europe, and playing in Germany was one of the great experiences of our life. And we were so excited about it. And I want you to give up another hand for Mr. Rick Brantley. That was his first show he ever played. It's the first time he's ever been in Europe. And you guys blew our mind. You were amazing. Thank you so much. This is the title track. We're going to play a bunch of songs for you from that album. I know it would have been better if it had been out, but we take the time we can. This song's called Reckless in Me. I started writing about my experiences in the rodeo. I used to be a cowboy in that. And I started writing about being a horse named Reckless, and I couldn't figure out halfway through the song if I was writing about a horse or my own personality. Up for you to decide. It's called Reckless in Me.
Thank you.
So when I started the first record, I had about 25 songs and I was going through them with a friend of mine and seeing which ones I wanted to try and record. And I was absolutely shocked to see how many songs I've written about drinking. And yeah, I finally got something back for it. So. We're going to play a few of those for you tonight. This one always makes me laugh. I was sitting in a bar not too long ago in California about 1:45 in the morning expecting something fantastic to happen in the last 15 minutes. And God knows if I've learned anything over 30 years, absolutely nothing fucking happens in the last 15 minutes. We're going to play this for you. It's called Going Home. Yeah.
You're gone.
This next song is about a lonely truck driver driving through the US 3,000 miles from one end to the other called Open Road. So I've been thinking about that I just basically wanted to have a drink with pretty much everyone I can meet. And this has been a really good way to do it. So if you happen to have a bottle, a glass, a cup in your hand, if you don't mind raising it, on behalf of myself and the band, you have no idea how much a night like this means to us. So, prost. So this used to be the first song in our set, and I would never introduce it, but I have to come clean on this now. The first time it was recorded, a bunch of friends of mine were there, and they were listening to it, and they liked the song, and they kept asking me who the girl was that I wrote about. And I wouldn't answer the question, and finally they got bored, and they went and asked a cigarette or a drink. And I was left alone in the studio with my 12-year-old daughter at the time. And she had this look on her face, and I looked at her, and I said, "What's up?" And she said nothing. And I said, "No, I can tell something's bothering you. What is it?" And she said nothing. I know what that song's about. And I said, "Do you think you know what that song's about? Why don't you tell me?" She said, "It's about that stupid bar on the corner." And she was right. And that was the moment I realized my 12-year-old daughter was smarter than I was. And I actually wrote a love song to a bar. It's called "Can't Stay Away." Thank you. This next song is the only cover I put on either album. I think it's a perfect country song. It was made very famous by a female singer, but I think it works just as well with a boy. It's called Blame It On Your Heart. Thank you. y'all. Make you dance a little bit. Here we go. Yeah.
phone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Jessica Patera, our drummer, who is just absolutely outstanding. And Jessica, this song goes out to all you tequila drinkers here, called Agave.